Hey everybody, it's Chris and Jen from RE/MAX Hallmarks Excellence Group, your trusted East End specialists. We have been getting asked all the time lately what's going on in the market, what's going to happen with COVID. And while we don't have a crystal ball, I think a lot of people turn their ears to us because we were one of the first people that correctly analyzed what the east to west migration caused by the RCMP and the military moving west would lead to. In any case, our takes on COVID and its impact, everyone's kind of hearing that the sky's falling, CMHC announcing 18 to 22% price reductions on homes. I actually ran into just yesterday, we had a rental listing, and three of the people looking to rent it had just arbitrarily sold their homes, trying to cash out before the market dropped and then hoping to jump back in when it crashed.
And another factor, Chris, you might not want to forget, is there was also 760,000 mortgages that were deferred in Canada as per CMHC article about 3 weeks ago that I read.
Yeah. So the long and the short of it is that, yes, I think we can all agree that there are going to be some bank repos. There's going to be some landlords that, after having had their tenants default on payment for 6 months in a row and they felt the financial pinch, have decided that they will no longer want to get into that. And then of course with the new legislation that that it's trying to get pushed through for not being able to do Airbnb unless you lived in the property, then that's going to further bring some properties on the market. But I think that we can agree that because there's such an extreme shortage, because Ottawa is such and surrounding areas are such in demand, being the hottest market area in Canada right now, because we have such a good sheltered economy, my personal feeling is that yes, we're going to have a bunch of properties that are going to come on the market. We will see a dip probably between end of November through to the end of December, and then they will be absorbed, those properties that do come on, and then we'll get back to, unfortunately for buyers, status quo, where it will continue to be a seller's market, I'm anticipating, through until at least spring 2022. What do you think about that?
Well, I don't think we're going to see another dip for at least, I'm thinking March 2021. I'm thinking the debt load is going to take its toll right after Christmas for some families and for some people due to COVID. And I believe that we're going to see a correction in the market probably in a year. Now, I'd have to do further studies on market statistics, a further analysis, but there's going to have to be a correction at some point, right, for sure.
Just looking at kind of what's gone on since COVID, I'm not sure if you're able to see that, but this is the new listings by week. Under my hand over here, these lines here kind of show as COVID was announced and as the lockdown began. Now we've got two lines. The blue line is the 2019 and the red line is 2020. So you can see that that as things kind of progressed, normally we get the early birds that get on. So we can see a little bit of a rise, and then we don't have many new listings typically, right? In that first little bit, things take off through the spring, right? Again, we're looking at the 2019 as the blue line. We had hardly anyone putting it on, oh, COVID, we can't do anything. And then they realized, well, there's people are demand. The ones that are going on are selling like hotcakes. So again, a buildup. Then at this certain point where normally in the summer things taper off, we actually had more listings in 2020 than in 2019. We see a normal dip here when we get less listings around that long weekend of August, right? Nobody wants to be doing anything. When you look back at some of these other dips, they coincide with things like, Easter weekend and things like that, where typically you don't want to start a new weekend on a weekend when, or a new listing when people would be away. And then, so you can see here that that they've just started to taper off. When we kind of superimpose and look at what's going on with the sold listings, looking at the same time. So now we're having less coming on the market and we're having more than ever that are selling, right? It's going to keep on driving that demand, right? There's more people looking than there are actually on the market. And that's evident as well in the sale prices. So again, we saw that people that jumped into the market right away after COVID started, they did all right. The prices had dropped. From there, they've steadily increased. And you can see that we have been not only more money than 2019, but pulling away from that same trend.
And they've increased by how much, Chris?
Well, I mean, I'm looking at all of Ottawa. Depending on the neighborhood, this gap that we're seeing, it can be 18%. Year over year, so absolutely incredible. And again, when we see this continual trend of prices going up, less inventory in the market, there's no indication at all that the sky is about to fall locally. Again, this, my take is that right now would be the best possible time for a trade up. So even though you're gonna pay more, the larger, more expensive houses haven't seen the kind of increase at the entry level houses. So certainly this would be a great time to trade up from a condo or a townhouse or an entry level, smaller detached to a mid-size, much larger one, because that divide, the disparity between that very, very base entry price range and a much larger single has never been smaller.
Chris, I have a question for you. So let's say somebody has been renting for a year or 2 years and they want to buy. What's your suggestion? How should they get into the market?
Well, it sure
with prices being so high.
It sure is a tough thing to do, but the reality is that even in a normal market, we're seeing, you know, 5, 6, 8% increases over a year. So if we just do quick math and we say on a $400,000 house, say on average, we're going up by 6% per year. Right? It means we're talking about a $25,000 increase. And then you could presume that during that same year, at a typical rent, you'd be spending $25,000. So if you look at it that way, every year you wait to jump into home ownership, there's that $50,000 divide. Now, of course, the people that jumped in last year and their friends didn't, their poor friends are hearing about them having made $100,000 and things like that. That's not typical and not likely to continue at that sort of frenzied rate. But certainly with still having relaxed laws in regards to foreign investors in Ottawa, where Toronto and Vancouver have implemented a 15% surcharge on these investors. Last year in Ottawa, one in 42 purchases was done by a foreign investor. Toronto, of course, has doubled their land transfer tax, their famous tax de bienvenue. Welcome to the community and break out the small fortune. So certainly Ottawa has become one of the favored places for investors as well.
Correct. And also to mention, there are some first-time home buyer incentive plans. So if you're a first-time home buyer and you'd like to discuss the purchase of a home, let us know, because there are some incentives for you using an RRSP and also avoiding your land transfer tax also as a first-time home buyer. So let us know, because we'd love to help you out with that.
Yeah, and certainly this is just a very broad overview, but Jen and I always have our ears to the ground and really pay attention to what's going on as far as statistically. When we're looking for a house for you, the buyer, we're not only going in and doing a comparative market analysis of your prospective purchase, but our mandate is kind of threefold. We want to make sure, A, that it meets all your needs, that it's the right house for your growing family or your downsizing family, whatever the need may be. Second thing, of course, is we want to make sure your equity is secured. We don't want to get a phone call next year that you have to move for whatever reason and you being in a loss situation. And of course, we want to make sure that structurally all the systems are adequate.
Correct. And also, because we service a lot of sellers and we do a lot of home appraisals, It helps us keep our ear to the ground on products that are coming to the market, so homes that are coming to the market. So oftentimes they don't hit MLS. And they end up in this crazy market selling over the asking price anyways. Yeah. So let us know if you are looking, because we could have some private sales going on as well. And we could include you in that because of the reach that we do, because of the amount of transactions we do every year.
I mean, the other advantage, and I mean, I think that's the reason why some of our sellers do take advantage of that, is we're able to put in the right buyer. We'll save them on commission, but we're also going to save having 40 plus strangers traipsing through their home in this time. I mean, certainly we're constantly upgrading our COVID protocol and making sure that that nobody's at risk.
Keeping you safe.
Yeah, but that being said, I mean, we do deal with a lot of people that are immunocompromised or at risk, and in looking at the cost benefit, they would much rather have just one person coming in and giving them a good dollar, and certainly that's why you see an awful lot of our signs that pop up with solds on them before they're on the market. Certainly we look forward to adding you to our.
So whether you're buying, whether you're selling, buying as an investor, buying for your forever home or your move up home, feel free to contact us. We would love to help you and guide you through this, what could be stressful process, exciting process for sure. And I mean, you're hiring realtors that have years of experience. Myself, it's 15 years of real estate. Chris is 13 years of real estate. Plus, my father was a realtor. Anyway, so you're hiring knowledgeable realtors. So give us a shout.
Have a great day.